All the brush fills that I will break down are available in the link provided below. To be honest, I really miss you guys, and I'm serious about it. And to compensate that, I'll be providing really, really amazing breakdowns to you guys. To start with, I have this one today. So hey everyone, welcome back to Fusion Studios, and today I have an amazing breakdown for you guys. So this is a client project work which I did. This was basically a recreational video. Now I don't have my inspector too. I'll enable that by clicking over here on the inspector, and I have my FB node over here and inspector. To start with, first of all, this is my whole comp, and I actually did it in 4K, but you know, I'm recording this too in my system and it's not that powerful, so that's why I changed it to Full HD, which is 1920 by 1080. Now to start with the background, also I have my guides applied to the viewer. You can do that by clicking onto the viewer, hitting Ctrl G to enable or disable guides. And if you want a guide particular to some camera frame, so right click, go to guides, frame aspect, and you can choose your frame aspect whichever you want. I always use a default one because it does the job, so I don't need that. So there are different underlays for different work. Okay, to start up with, I have this background, cards, subject, OFX, and text. So to start with, of course, we'll go with the background, and here I have this background. In this background itself, we have a background node. In this background node, I have changed the type to gradient, okay, so that we have this smooth color gradient. So we use a complementary scheme of blues and oranges. Okay, I know it's very basic, but it did the work. Then I added a grid. You can see the settings over here. Of course, that's why I have enabled my inspector, and I mask it up with the fast noise. With that, if I play now, well, a little bit of motion, not too much, but it's doing the work which I want. How to put a 2D object and convert it into a 3D one by using an image plane. And if I hold Alt and with my middle mouse, I can rotate around the pivot point of this object. I'll click on it, select that, hit F, and now it's oriented. Then after that, I also have these two texts over here. So what this is, let me show it to you. It's just the name of this guy. Okay, in this text, if I go over here, I have a font which is Poppins, weight is extra bold, size a little bit increased. Then if I go to layout, everything is as it is except the center x and y values, which means that it is just transform. That's nothing else. And in the shading panel, if I'll go, you can see here my white solid fill is checked and the appearance is set to text outline. Alright, my thickness is a little bit thinner. Same goes with this one. And the text animation is different over here. And if we join everything together, so it gives me something like this, you see. It looks nice on the 3D space at least. And here, this background and text is connected with my camera. So I have made different scenes, like this background is different, text is different, subject, everything is different, but the camera is same. So we have different 3D scenes, but they followed same camera. So that's why the animation will be similar. Not similar, it will be exactly same. Okay, so we are done with the background. Next, what I will show to you will be our cards, because that's the thing which I made after background. First of all, if I just show you both of these together, so the final output looks something like this. All right. So actually, when I, you know, storyboarded it, of course, we did everything from scratch. We took inspiration from that video because client wanted the recreation of that video only. But of course, we used our own creativity and, you know, made this shot completely different from that. So here are these three cards, which come from right side and flips and stays at a place. I have these three different videos, all right? First one, second one, and third one. And if I play, these all three plays, all right? Of course, because they're videos. Then what I did was, I merged this background thing on top to give it a nice subsurface scattering type of an effect, okay? Same with this one, and same with this one. And how I made this effect is using a white background. On this white background, I put a rectangle. Okay, I'll pause the playback. Now in this rectangle, I selected invert and increase the softness a little bit. Okay, now you can play with corner radius, width, height, and you know, all that settings, like however you want. Then I copied that and pasted after it, like on top of it. And then I increase border width and reduce the softness a little bit so that I have thick white edges. And then, you know, this just gradients out, like it just fades away. So that's why I made it like that and then put it on top of this background. First, I thought to make it like blue, but I don't need that. It automatically looks a little bit bluish because of the videos. Then what I did was I put this on an image plane, okay, like all three of these. So right now I guess this doesn't have any animation. It doesn't, okay, so it's just as it is. And on the image plane 3D, it looks something like this, okay. All three of these looks something like this. Then what I thought was I needed something, because when I will animate these, so for example, if I show you this one, right, how I animated it. So if I'll play, I'll hit F first of all. Yeah, just like that. So till 25th frame, this card is over here, okay. And on, let me just reduce, like turn off the lighting mode. So if you'll come over here, you can change the mode from solid, light, shadows, wireframe. You know, if I'll go to wireframe, it will show me the wireframe look of it because it's 3D, of course. I'll click on solid and let's play from 25th. So this is the animation which I did onto this separate transform node, which you should always do, because the image plane 3D's offset should be as it is, you know, it should be like that only, how it was earlier. If you want to do some changes, do it with the transform, whether it's 2D or 3D, doesn't matter. All of these cards have kind of similar values, okay. They are on the right side. If I enable my spline, you can see all the settings over here. The X offset is obviously animated because it's moving in the horizontal way. Then we have the Y rotation because it's flipping, and also the X scale, like not just X scale but scale value, it increases its size a little bit, and with time it also decreases, so it's something like that. I'll select all of these, moving in spline, hitting Control A, and then clicking over here, Control Fit to zoom. I have all of these. I'll just disable X offset and X scale. This is not just simpler, like simple smooth, like you just hit Shift S or F and it works. No, it's not like that. If I'll do Control A, so easing in and easing out has been done till a level to 80, which is I think a lot, but I needed that from slow to very fast, to very fast to slow. That movement, that kind of movement, we can get with ease in and ease out, which we did over here, right? But still, it was looking very empty, you know, like it's just a simple thin card, like it doesn't give that, you know, blocky feel. So for that, what I did was I added this shape. I made this shape in Fusion. I'll go to normal, turn off this normal's intention. Yeah, okay, now it's fine. So I, in Shape 3D, selected this cube and changed its width, height, and depth, obviously similar to this card itself, okay. Yeah, I manually did it, in case if you're wondering how I get this so perfect. So I manually did it by zooming in a lot. I chose this cube and give it a material using a background node. In this background, again I chose it to grade, chose the type to gradient, and in this gradient I set it to radial. You can see x and y values and change the color a little bit, then merging it behind this, and then putting the animation node, this transform node of course, after it. So this cube also follows the transformation which this plane follows, like both of these follows the same transformation values. If I'll play from 25th, you can see that our animation is happening while the cube is also rotating, or you can say flipped, and it looks good with motion blur. Movements in 3D, just they are just chef's kiss, to be honest. Same happens with this one, just the keyframes are a little bit delayed. Same goes with the third one, again keyframes are a little bit delayed. Then we have merge, and in this merge you can see everything is just put over here, right? First one, second one, third one, and same camera goes into this one, like in this merge via this pipe router. And if I show this and render, so it looks something like this, and it looks good, right? And in this render 3D, I change the render type to hardware render. That's it, nothing else. Now to get the shadows, what I did was I used a technique, okay. This is my own personal technique. I made this, yes, while doing this. I was using Drop Shadow actually, but my colleague used a shadow which is known as Real Shadow, and it's available I guess on, I don't know, Reactor or something. But I personally don't use that, so I thought why not to try it on to these nodes, right, which I have present in Fusion. So what I did was I took the render, put it into the slide trays. In the slide trays, the normal ray drop off is set to default. I change it to CCD Bloom Soft, reduce the soften to 0.01, length is something like this, and brightness is something like this. Put that into the bitmap. In bitmap, change the channel to luminance. Put it into the background. Of course, background will be black. Put this behind our render, okay, using this merge, and boom, you got this beautiful, beautiful shadow. It looks really good, to be honest. You can change the light placement, okay, like position of it, so it actually looks that it's the light has been put in 3D. So now everything merged on top looks something like this. Our background, and this background I guess has been animated. No, it's the camera itself. Okay, so the camera is animated. If I enable this, my focal length is 35. Okay, everything is as it is, I guess. I'll go to my transform, and here in my transform, my transition Z values and rotational Z values has been animated. I'll click Control A, zoom fit to view, and you can see we have some keyframing going on. So over here, my easy in or out values is 60-40. Same goes over here, 60 and simple 33, but it can be considered as 40. And this one is 33, like simple, okay. So this and this, I hit Shift S to make it smoother, but this and this, I change it to 60-40. I don't know why it's showing me 37 now. Same goes with this one, 60-40. Okay, so like it smoothens. And also I applied a lens blur after this background render from frame number 13 to 30, because these cards were popping up, and in actual 3D space what happens is when a new thing pops up, the behind one gets blurred out. So that is when I'm mimicking. Okay, that is it. That's how these things are working till now. I guess that I'm not missing any point, right? If I am, so please comment down below and I'll be very glad to share the answer with you. Next, let's talk about text a little bit. Here we have the text. In this text, if I show you the settings again, font is Poppins. Okay, now in this one I have used a modifier known as follower. You can right click, choose a modifier by clicking over here. Okay, in follow modifier, I change the delay type to 2 and change its size values, so it gives us this kind of an animation. So let me show you what I did, and I'll also show the keyframes. All right, now if I'll go to shading panel over here, in I guess I didn't do anything on rotation, right? So I don't need this. Yeah, I can remove that. Okay, so these were not doing anything. In the size panel, you can see that on 30th it's set to 0, on 35th it's set to 1.15. okay, it's a little bit increased than default. Then after 2-3 frames it has been lowered to default, which is 1. So it is giving us this popping animation. Okay, help it. So that's it. That's how I animated this text. And also again, delay type is set to 2. You can change the order from automatic to inside out or outside in. Let's see. Okay, so outside in looks something like this. Inside out will look something. Again, you can play with it and you will get a good result. So if you're satisfied, then it's fine. If not, so, you know, keep playing and get a desired result. Then with transform, I changed it, you know, changed its translation and scale values. Again, I told you, don't do anything on the node itself. Do it with the transform in 3D space. That would be very helpful. Then with merge, I attached it with a camera. All right, you can see camera is here. Then in renderer, this looks something like this, because the camera is also moving. It is changing its position, Z position. Then again, applying the same technique over here, I use this light rays mode. I use this light rays node. Then with bitmap, same settings, CCD Bloom Soft, increase length, decrease softness, increase brightness. Bitmap, channel is set to luminance, black background, putting it behind the renderer, and it looks something like this, which is quite nice. I also used an ambient occlusion over here to get the shadows, because I didn't use lighting and like real lighting and shadow, so that's why I am evicted using bright ambient occlusion. So basically it just takes the shadow pass from the renderer. Okay, if I enable that right now, you can see nothing is happening. But if you go to output channels, enable Z and normal. Z is for depth, normal is for the basically faces. Okay, so to get that data, and in ambient occlusion we are taking that data and darkening it. That's it. Of course you need to change the output mode from AO to color, okay, to see the color. And other settings look something like this, but I can make a dedicated video on this if you need to, or if don't, then you know, you can always ask in the comments below. Then with the shadow and everything, it looks something like this finally. But there's this node which is known as edge detect. It helped me a lot, to be honest. And boom, with that you get these edges which looks so beautiful and makes the comp, takes the comp to the next level. Just see this for a moment, it looks so good, man. Like seriously, just because of these edge detect nodes. Now we're done with the text, and till now our comp looks something like this. Next we have our subject. This is something which was boring for me because I was enjoying this, but again you have to do that stuff, right? So this is this guy. I know I took a very random picture, but this is this guy. Then again add this edge detect to add some soft glow. With the transform I flipped it using this flip option over here, put it on the 3D with the help of image plane, transform to animated on zero. It will be not showing onto the render. 35th it will be showing up. And again attaching the camera with Moist 3D in renderer, changing it to hardware renderer because it's a little bit faster. If you have GPU you should use hardware renderer, but sometimes it doesn't work, so use software. I don't know, whatever works for you works for you. And it finally looks something like this. All right, and again that shadow thing, light rays, bitmap, background merge, putting it behind, we have this shadow, this kind of shadow. I use lens blur here again to mimic that same thing. Let me show you. So on 20th it looks something like this, but then it is getting blurred out because this is something which is way front in Z position, and the background is something which is backwards in Z position. So I blurred both of these and just put the text and cards as it is. All right, and it looks good, right? Then with OFX, what I did was, in this OFX underlay, let me make it a little bit bigger. Yeah, over here, I first of all used an image, okay, this one, to get that lens dirt effect. In this brightness contrast, you can see I have reduced the saturation to zero. With Lumac here, I took out all the black part. I know it took out like details from it, but it's fine for me because I wanted just this kind of dirt on, little bit spread all over, just like that. All right, then with the help of lens distortion, I distorted it a little bit. Glow, you know how glow works, soft glow, all the settings are here. Then I use this new node which I usually don't use, but this time I tried it and it looked good, which is lens reflections. Okay, you can see it looks good. Then with prism blur, film grain and media out, it looks something like this. So that is it guys for the breakdown. Again, if you want the file, it's provided in the link below. If you want to learn all of this from me, again you can DM me via in my mail or any other way which I will be able to know that you want to learn. I'll be very glad to teach you. And also if you want your project done from me like these types, okay, or anything else, we can see, we can check that later. So my business inquiries mail is also provided in the description below. You can check all the links from description below, get any of my files, you know, anything else, like description is the thing to go. Again, if you like this video, then you know what to do. Like this video, subscribe to the channel, press the notification bell so that you won't miss any other breakdown which I'll be doing pretty soon, okay, because you will be having really really good breakdowns. And yeah, that's it. See you in the next one. Till then, peace. Peace out.